Why we invented the sine law for triangles. Okay, so if you're given the triangle ABC, can you see triangle ABC? All right, and you're given two corners and one side. Well, the rule is if you know three parts of a triangle, you can figure out all the rest. But you know what? This would be a nasty one if you had to do this without the special sine law. Watch this. Are you ready? So trust me in my math. Here we go. All right. So I'm going to turn that triangle. There's no 90 degree corner. I'm going to turn it into two right angle triangles. All right. And then I'm going to calculate how high this side is here. Are you ready? So, I'm going to break this into two pieces, right? X is from there to there, and Y is from there to there. So I could say that the height of the triangle, measured from this corner, from the right corner there, is going to be X times 10, 30. Do you believe me? Well, trust me, it's true. All right? And if I measured from this corner, all right, now you're going, but we don't know that angle. Well, we do know that angle because the triangle sum theorem says the inside angles add up to 180. So that's got to be 80, doesn't it? Right? So that's got to be an 80. So that height is both X 10, 30, and it's also Y 10, 80. Isn't that cool? Well, if that equals that and that equals that, doesn't that mean that that equals that? All right? So, and we also know that Y is really the whole length 10 minus however long X is, so we could say Y is 10 less the length of X. So now we know that that equals that. All right, so now we know that X 10 30 equals 10 minus X times 10 80. All right, can you buy that? Right, this is called algebra, by the way. Right, if you don't like this, don't worry, this isn't essential math, no way. All right, this is like pre-cal math. All right. So then you're going, well, I want to get all the X's on one side, all right? So I got X 10, 30 here, and I'm going to bring this, right? And this factors out, right? So this is 10, 10, 80, and X 10, 80, all right? Now I'm going to get the X's together, so I bring this X 10, 80 over to here, and then I can factor out the X, if you know what I mean. So believe me, this is all going to work. All right, so this might be a little advanced. I could explain it to you if you hang out at the end of the day. There, so far, that's what I got. And then, of course, I'm just going to get rid of this term here, a correction, this factor here, 10, 30 plus 10, 80. So I pop it back underneath. So now we know how long length X is. Length X is 10, 10, 80, all divided by 10, 30 plus 10, 80. And when you do that on a calculator, it's 9.07. Right, so if that's 9.07, that means that that's got to be what, 0.93. All right, so now we know that's 0.93. So now we can do the tan of the 30 is equal to the opposite over the, oh, actually, we already know that this, so now we can figure out, we know the height. All right, so the tan of 30 will calculate the height. So if I use this 30 degree angle, I'll calculate the height now because I know this. So I'll come back to this corner. So it turns out the height using the tan for the 30 degree corner is 5.24. Now I can use the 5.24 there and the 0.93 there and Pythagorean theorem to calculate that. All right, so yeah, this would be a lot of calculating, a lot of algebra, a lot of identities and things. And when I do all that, I end up with the square root of 28.3225, blah, blah, blah. And you end up with about 5.32. So this one's way, don't do this one. This is one way to do it if you were in pre-cal, but you're not in pre-cal. All right, let me show you how the sine law would do this. Are you ready? Here we go. Boom. There it is. There's all there is to it. You ready? So in the sine law, that's all you're going to do. You're going to say that side C compared to the sine of the corner across from it is equal to side B compared to the sine of the corner across from it. So you're just going to do side angle pairs, and then you just pop that up to there. The sin 30 pops up to there. Right, cross multiply, boom, it's a proportion. And when you plug that in, it's going to be 5.32. All right, now which one do you think was easier? Do you think it was easier to do this thing here? Or did you want to do that thing there? Oh my God. All right, so turns out we're kind of happy that we invented the sine law. That's a little more effective and expeditious than doing that. This works, but you probably just want to know the sine law complete.